morning, everyone. Carol here at Oak House Journals. Thank you so much for coming and joining me today. I've been watching the lovely Luise Heinzel. Now, she's been doing swaps with various people where they've been swapping five items, and you use those five items to make something. And you can only use the five items that you've been sent. You can't add to it. But you can use what I would term the tools of the trade or tools of our craft. And I believe also use the packaging that the five items came in. So with that in mind, I very sneakily sent to two of my lovely friends, Leanne in Australia and my lovely friend Jeff in Las Vegas, I sent them five items and set them the challenge, because I don't think it's a swap. I actually think it's quite a challenge to limit whatever you create to just those five items. So as I say, I sent them both five items and set them the challenge, if they wanted to do it, of creating something. Now, I'm going to show you today what Jeff has made for me. Leanne's is still in the make or in the process, and I'm not going to share with you what I sent to her, but I will share with you what I sent to Jeff. So I sent him a couple of sheets of this vintage ledger paper. Whoops, this vintage German ledger paper. So he had some sheets of that. I sent him a portion of this fabric that I have in my stash, so I sent him a portion of that. I sent him some pale blue piano roll paper, which I thought would blend with this quite nicely. I sent him a vintage Kodak slide, and I also sent him a contemporary postcard that looked vintage. So that was what his five items were. And I packaged them in a white paper bag, and then it was wrapped with tissue paper, this Avril twine, and I put a little wax seal on it. Now, let me show you what he created, and I think it's fantastic. Look at this. So he used the piano roll paper behind here and then layered up over the top of the strips of ledger paper, the fabric. He did ink round the edges, which is tools of the trade, but look how fabulous that is. If you lift up the fabric, you can see the details behind of the ledger paper, and I just think that's amazing. And then the vintage slide, I'm not sure whether you can see that, he set into the side of this, and this actually is a, if I can find the right end to open, a tuck spot or a pocket to go in a journal. And this inside portion, he's used the paper bag, and then he's layered the vintage paper, ledger paper, and the piano roll paper and the fabric on the top, and this slide is set into it. And if I flip it over, again, he's used more of the ledger paper here, and he's cut up the postcard to add interest. And I just think that is amazing. So, Jeff, a massive 10 out of 10. I think that is awesome. And setting in that slide and using it as kind of like a little window inset into this bag is just fabulous. And I did have an idea of what I thought he might do with that slide, but he's obviously blown that out of the water and done this instead. So I just think that is amazing. And I will have such fun adding that to one of my journals. So thank you so much, Jeff. That is absolutely brilliant. Jeff has got his own back, because he has sent me some items for me to have a go at this challenge. And I'm going to show you what they are. So first off, I have all my goodies inside a plain file folder. So this is a cream file folder. So because this is packaging, I will be able to use this. And inside I have a spool of this kind of metallic thread. Now this is very, very fine. So this looks like machine thread to me. And Jeff did very funnily say that the thread was not so good and I could swap this out if I wanted to, because Jeff said that this keeps on breaking. Now my machine isn't particularly good at using metallic thread. It's just a basic sewing machine. So if Jeff had issues with this, then I think I'm definitely going to have issues with it, but I will try. He then sent me, I'm just going to take that letter away, because Jeff sent me a letter with some rules and a little bit of an explanation about what all this is. So he's also sent me three pieces. If I open them up here, three lovely, lovely pieces of some home rusted fabric. And what he's done is he's done leaf stamps on these. And this is textured in a beautiful, almost like a dull gold colour. And then as you can see, here's some of his rusting. So I've got three portions or three pieces of that that I can use. And I've also got these two lovely pieces. Now he's done some collaging on here and then he's glued them on a backing. So I've got two pieces of that that I could use. Then I have this gorgeous set of lyrics here about Pippin. Now, Pippin is Jeff's beautiful Cavalier Spaniel that he lost fairly recently. And then he sent me this little picture, and this is his gorgeous Pippin girl. So those are the things that I've got to play with to create a piece. So I was having a look at what I've got here and trying to come up with some ideas. Now, thank goodness Jeff has sent me this file folder, because what I thought I could do initially was to create a jumbo tag to use the fabric on the front and put a layered image of Pippin on the front using some of this collage paper, and then have the poem on the back, and then I could stitch round it using my thread. Now, because I sent this to Jeff, when he sent me all of this, it was wrapped also in some tissue paper with this Avril twine, so I could use that as the topping for my tag. And I could also use this little wax seal that, as I say, was part of the packaging that I sent to Jeff and he sent it back. So I could also use that and maybe punch a hole in that, put an eyelet in and have it as a dangle on my tag. So I was thinking that that might work. Then I thought, well, I've got lots of card here. I could perhaps maybe do a double tag and use my fabric here and hinge the tag so that I have the fabric on the outside of my tag, open it up, inside have the file folder and ink stencil on that, and have an image of Pippin inside with the poem on the other side, and then on the back obviously my fabric. So I was liking that idea because it would give me an opportunity to use a lot of this card from the file folder, and I think that would be quite nice having it as kind of like a hinge tag, or even if I didn't do it as a hinge tag, I could do it as a little kind of little folder without having the tapering at the top. But I quite like the idea of being able to use these. So that was the next follow-on idea I had. But what I would really, really like to do is to create a little journal. Now, I haven't got any paper that even if I use this as a cover or this as a cover, I haven't got any paper. I can bind it together because I can sew it, and to use wax thread and three-hole pamphlet stitch or five-hole pamphlet stitch, I could do that because, again, that's tools of our craft. So I was trying to get my head round it, and I actually think that what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this lovely fabric, and if I fold it in half like it is like so, then I could actually use this like so as my the size of my little journal, and I could use each one of these as double pages inside like that, and then this one as well. So using these as my pages, slot one inside the other, okay, like so, and if I stitch round these, then I think that will be some decoration and interest. What I also thought I could do is embroider on the front cover and the back cover. I also thought that because I'm not going to have much rigidity, even though these the material is folded in half to create the pages, what I could do is use the file folder inside, slotted inside, to actually give me a little bit of rigidity, and I will have enough, or I'm sure, fingers crossed, I've got enough. If I cut it this way, that I will have enough to make three strips for making my pages a bit more robust. So that's what I'm planning to do. I thought also that what I could do is I could actually cut up the lyrics, each one of these sections, and mount it on this card. And again, I think I will have enough that I can do all three, which will leave me enough to put Pippin on another piece, and then sew those inside the journal on the pages. So this is the piece I'm going to work with for my cover. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go away and I'm going to just pick out, I think, the veins on here with my thread and see if I want to do any other embroidery on here. But I think I'll just keep it very, very simple. And I will be back when that's done, everybody. This is what the embroidered cover looks like now. And I'm hoping that you can just pick out that I've done stem stitch, trying to pick up all the veins on each of the leaves on this piece. And perhaps if I hold it up against that one, you can see the slight difference or definition that I've got there. I haven't done it on all of these. I'm just doing it on the cover. I mean, this on its own took me 3 full evenings to do. I have changed out the thread. If you remember, Jeff gave me this metallic thread to use. My machine just wouldn't take it at all. And for hand embroidery, it was flaking. So because Jeff gave me permission to change it out, I changed it out for this pan of truffle. As you can see, it's a CGT thread, a cottage garden thread that I had in my stash. It's a stranded cotton and it's absolutely gorgeous and was the perfect match for this. As you can see, it's got a slight variation in the thread colour, which was just beautiful. So I used that and had a lovely time stitching with that. Those are my pieces trimmed and ready to go. This is all I have left of the file folder. So I chopped the file folder up, but these are my pieces that are going to go inside my pages to give some rigidity. So if I just open out the center one, pop that inside like so, and I just want those to go inside to give some rigidity. Now, as you can see, they're slightly fractionally larger than my fabric, and I cut them deliberately like that so that I would have enough to trim away and make sure I've got a really neat edge and a fraction at the bottom. So what I'm going to do is pop those inside, and I will be stitching round each page on the sewing machine. What I'm going to work on now is doing the nameplate from the front cover and getting that in place. So I thought you might like to see how I've got on. What I've done is I've bonded my pieces of fabric to the cardstock, which is inside. And to do that, I used bonder web. On this occasion, I preferred to use it because I wasn't sure how the fabric would take Beacon 3-in-1 glue or Fabri-Tac, and sometimes that can bleed through. And I always find it gives a really nice finish, and I wanted this one to be as good as I could get it. So all my pieces of fabric have been stuck to my cardstock, as you can see, and they will go inside my journal like that. So now what I need to do is I need to trim the sides and the bottom. The top is a folded piece of fabric, or a fold of the fabric, so I won't want to do that. On the front cover, I've used some of this layering that came with my pieces to work with, and I've used that for my backing pieces for the lyrics, as you can see here. And on the front, what I've done is I've actually stitched it to the fabric and the cardstock before I actually put down the second piece of fabric. So you can't see the stitching, although there is a slight raised area there where the stitching is covered by the fabric. And if I'm perfectly honest, I had planned to do exactly the same with each of these pieces inside the journal on these pages, but I was so busy nattering that I forgot to do that and iron down the fabric all the way. So I'm actually going to have to glue those on here, because I don't actually want the stitching to show through on the other side, which is a shame. And that's a lesson for me to learn: pay attention and not natter. But with this one, I actually did stitch it. As I've said, I cut each piece with my deckle edged guillotine. The three pieces of this Avril twine that I had, if you remember, it was varying lengths. Well, what I managed to do is I've joined it behind here so that you don't actually see the join at all, and I've put a knot at the end of my three pieces on either side, and this edge here will be stitched under the pamphlet stitch when I do that, and also when I stitch all the way around all my pages, which I will do in a minute once I've neatened up the edges. I'm going to trap the thread behind my machine stitching so that it actually is fixed in place across the back and not flapping around. So that's my intention there. As I said, I've cut up the lyrics and I've created mats for them. I used Distress Oxide Vintage Photo and also Distress Ink Wild Honey to just ink round the edges to add a little bit of interest, to try and blend the cardstock in with the colours of the leaves on the front or on the pages. And rather than stitch all the way around, I've just stitched down each side with a double layer of messy stitching just for interest. And I will be gluing these together and then sticking them on my pages in just a moment. I've also trimmed round the edge of the lovely picture of Pippin. I've also done some messy stitching round the outside, and she will be going in the journal too. This is the nameplate that I'm going to put on the front. And this one I did stitch all the way around, and that one's going to be glued on the front like that in a moment. And I also, using the letter that I, or my letter of instructions that I got with my five pieces to play with, I took my piece of A4 paper and I folded it in half, or roughly in half, sorry, not quite in half. I folded it roughly in half, so you can probably just make out the ghosting of the printed text behind. And then I just swooshed it through some distress oxide, some vintage photo, and I used some acrylic gold paint to add some splatters, inked around the edges, and stitched all the way round. Now my intention originally was to put little wee Pippin inside here like so, but it left me with a single page with no decoration inside the journal, so I've decided not to do that. So Pippin has a page to herself. And I'm not quite sure what I'm going to do with this little piece. I will put it in the journal, and perhaps it could be journaled on or written on. I created a little band here because there was a fold from where the letter was originally folded, and it took the ink and left a line across there. So I thought it would be quite nice to create a little band here to act as my closure. I did think maybe I might put the wax seal on there, but I'm going to use that for something else. I keep on changing my mind about that wax seal. So that will be glued onto one of the pages in the journal, and I might do some more decoration on that. I'm just trying to keep this very, very simple. So that's where I've got so far, and I will carry on and do my stitching, neaten my edges, do some stitching, and then attach these pieces, and then I will come back to you with the end result. So here we go, everybody. This is my finished little journal. As you can see, I've made tried to make a bone charm for on the front using some of the leftover card from the file folder. It's just on a little jump ring there, so Jeff can take it off if he doesn't like it. For me, the jury's out as to whether I like it or not. So that's what the front looks like, and if I flip it over, that's what the back looks like. Of course, all the cover and the pages are now stitched with a couple of rows of messy machine stitching, and I just use basic cotton to match the cover. The front obviously is all layered up now and glued in place, and I've stitched it all together with three hole pamphlet stitch just down the spine here. Just using the Avril twine, as I mentioned before, for the closure. And going inside, this is my first page. This wax seal. So many ideas about what I wanted to do with that, but I decided in the end to put it in the front here, just to hide the slight raise that I've got here on the front cover, as a result of the stitching that I did to get that piece in place. And then I've put a couple of these decorative pieces on each of the pages, but they will serve as little tuck spots if Jeff wants to put a little tag in there, or slot in a little note. So they are actually pockets, although they just look like decorative pieces. And the reason I wanted to include those in a couple of places in the journal was just to balance it out and pick up the layering that I've done behind the lyrics. So that's the first set of lyrics in there. And then going over the page, there's another one of the tuck spots up there. There's the lyrics continued there. I've got a little bit of fraying on this, and normally what I would have done is I would have used something like fray stop on this, but I wasn't sure with this fabric how it would work, so I haven't actually done that. I just keep on trimming the edges. The bonder web that I use to adhere the fabric to the cardboard that's inside the pages will eventually stop that fraying, as will the double rows of messy stitching that I've done around each page. So this is the centre of my journal, and again another little tuck spot, pocket, or whatever you want to call it down there. I did another one of these little bones up there. I decided to put a couple of little eyelets in there just for the tiniest bit of thread that I had left. And then when I did that, I thought, well, it looked a bit bare on this side. And so I made another one of the little bones using a scrap of card and just inked round the outside. And if ever I wanted the Ranger doggy stamp that Stampus Anonymous did, this was the project I wanted it for. Because obviously there's paw prints on there, there's bones. I wouldn't have had to freehand draw this. And I think there's other whimsical things on that stamp. But because I didn't have the stamp, I couldn't use it, which was a shame, because I would have liked to have put some little paddy paw prints on maybe some of these lyrics. I certainly would have liked to have included it on here. So there's my little tiny scrap up there that I managed after much time and effort to tie a little wee bow. And of course, this is the darling Pippin. I didn't want to do anything more with this page. I love the fabric. I chose these two pages specifically because they are so gorgeous. The outline and the definition on these two pages is just amazing, Jeff. And I wanted them to obviously shine out and be pride of place for little Pippin there. So she just sits there looking gorgeous. And then this is my final page. As you can see, the embroidery from the other side of the cover comes through. I put a little bit of Jeff's layering on the belly band that's holding this in place. I haven't done anything in here. This is where I would have liked to have had some paw prints or some stamped images of bones or whatever that I could have put on here, but I decided to leave it plain and simple. And I was again toying with the idea of putting the final scrap of the letter that I had left over in here for Jeff to journal on, but I just thought I'd leave it because Jeff, if you want to, you can journal straight on top of the inking that I've done here, or you can maybe put some plain paper on and journal if you want to. So I've just left it plain, or maybe even if you have another couple of small pictures of Pippin, you could put those in there if you wanted to. So I've just left that really, really plain and simple, and I'm just hoping against hope that you like what I've created and that I've done justice to my attempt at doing a wee homage to little Pippin. So there we go. Thank you so much, Jeff, for setting me this challenge. It was a challenge. It's actually quite nerve-wracking doing these, because I would normally test out inks on the fabric or the paper just to see if the colour was right or how it took. As I mentioned, I would use fray stopper on the edge, but I wasn't sure how that would take. And similarly with the fabric glue, I didn't know whether that I'd get some seepage with this fabric. And that's why I went with the bonder web, because you've only got the pieces that you were given. So you can't afford to make any mistakes. And I did have a little bit of the letter that Jeff sent me left over after making that little journaling spot in the back to play with, to see whether or not the inks would be the right colour for when I actually came to make the little journaling spot. But there we go. I thoroughly enjoyed this challenge. Thank you so much, everybody, for watching. Take care. Bye-bye now.